हेलो एवरीवन, आई वेलकम यू टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल प्रोफेसर सिविल मंडल। हियर आई बेसिकली डिस्कस अबाउट सिविल इंजीनियरिंग एंड यू विल फाइंड ऑल माय वीडियो लेक्चर्स रिगार्डिंग सिविल इंजीनियरिंग, वेरियस टॉपिक्स ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग ओवर हियर। सो आफ्टर वी आर डन विद द रोड कंस्ट्रक्शन हिस्ट्री, द प्लानिंग एंड ज्योमेट्रिक डिज़ाइन ऑफ हाईवेज, ट्रैफिक इंजीनियरिंग एंड पेमेंट मटेरियल्स एंड देयर डिज़ाइंस, नाउ वी आर अप टू द फाइनल टॉपिक, दैट इज़ द हाईवे मेंटेनेंस। एंड अपॉन यूजेज ऑफ रोड्स, अ हाईवे हैज़ टू बी मेंटेन्ड एंड शुड बी ऑपरेटेड इन अ नाइस एंड अ इकोनॉमिकल मैनर। सो लेट्स रीड अबाउट दिस, द वेरियस लेवल्स और डिग्रीज ऑफ, एक्चुअली आई विल ट्राई टू finish this chapter quickly as this thing is completely theoretical and doesn't require much of the explanation and is very easy to understand, so you won't be requiring much help from my side. So I'll be briefly summarizing the whole of the chapter in front of you. So there are various levels or degrees of maintenance operation. That is, first is the routine maintenance, which includes that of drainage facilities. Second is the periodic maintenance or the patch repair, where the patch repair is taken place. And third is the special repairs or relaying or overlay positions. So here are some standards given in the table. You can go through it. MORTH, that is the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, has proposed to divide the maintenance program in three categories. So what are they? Level 1 represents the highest safety level, highest level of comfort and safety. Level 2 signifies the level to which the road deteriorated after 2 years of service before any maintenance is implemented. And level 3 represents the minimum level needed to provide a reasonable level of safety. So the table 2.10.2, you can see the various levels and the serviceability indicators and the corresponding percentages for the levels of the roads. So next we come to the maintenance of the earth roads. So as you know, earth is a very soft material as compared to bitumen or concrete or any other material. So earthen roads are basically, they require a huge amount of maintenance and operation, and mainly what we deal is the maintenance of the cross section. The cross section maintenance is a challenge in case of the earthen roads. So the maintenance of earthen roads includes the maintaining the cross section and also the dust nuisance in dry weather or summer. So in dry weather, such roads actually emit a lot of dust. Also, one more thing you must note down, damaged by heavy rains. They get damaged when the rains are very heavy. So they require a lot of maintenance, in other words you can say. And in case of low traffic rural roads, the routine or periodical maintenance of adding earth and rolling to bring the cross section of the design shape may be done manually. So wherever you see very low traffic is there, and mostly in earthen roads in village areas mainly, you will find a very less amount of traffic. So the routine maintenance can be done manually over there. For other types, you can use a motor grader or a drag with iron plates or angle irons for shaping the cross section. Next is the maintenance of gravel or morum roads. They actually include filling lost material, grading, dragging, addition of gravel along with adequate rolling. So re-graveling may be done up to adding 25 to 75 mm loose thickness of gravel into once in 2 to 5 years. So once in 2 to 5 years, adding 25 to 75 mm loose thickness of gravel is allowable, and this is known as the re-graveling. Next is the maintenance of the WBM or waterbound macadam roads. So the defects arise due to the following things. rutting, potholes, corrugations, raveling and edge damage. What are ruttings? Ruttings can be prepared. So about ruttings, they can be repaired by scarifying and removing the loose stones, filling with metal. So rutting actually happens whenever you will find some amount of loose stones coming up to the surface of the road. So this can be just repaired by removing the loose stones, filling with metal, partly salvaged with partly fresh. And next is the potholes. Potholes are formed, this is a very major problem in Indian roads, formed because of poor quality stones. The stones will be of poor quality and local failure of the subgrade. So patch repairs are done to fill the potholes. Next is the corrugations. Corrugations is like a formation of a wavy surface and which actually causes a discomfort. So corrugation is like the corrugated sheets which are used in the top of the roof. Corrugation is the appearance comes out like that only. It's a wavy structure up and down, and this thing actually causes discomfort. So variety of factors such as inadequate and defective rolling, vibration set up by pneumatic tires of vehicles and shock absorbers are also those set up by braking action contribute to the formation of corrugations. So these are the things which contribute to the corrugations. But the excessive blindage material, if any, collected on the surface should be removed by dragging and or by brooming. So by dragging or brooming, you will remove the extra surface. Next is the raveling. Raveling can be prevented to some extent by binding with a good binder. So use of good binder and material and watering can prevent raveling. Edge damage, it is caused by the loss of shoulder support. Repair should be done promptly, and periodic renewals of WBM surface is required, preferably once in 3 to 6 years. Maintenance of bituminous roads. In addition to standard cases such as traffic, weather and ingress of water for the deterioration of earth, gravel and WBM roads, loss of volatiles, oxidation of the binder materials and inadequacy of the specification and construction standards also could be the reason for distress and disintegration of the bituminous pavement. So these are the reasons why the distress and disintegration of bituminous pavements take place. Depending upon the degree of deterioration of the highway facility, the nature of the maintenance operations for bituminous pavement could be like, first is the patch repair. In patch repair, patching up, we actually patch up the potholes and localize failure, and maybe up to about 25% of the surface area annually. Next is the surface treatment. So after the patching is not, we find that the patching repair is not sufficient and it becomes uneconomical, it may also be so we use the surface treatment then only, and it can be used to improve the skid resistance when the surface is worn out badly. The standard specifications for tack coat, prime coat and seal coat along with surface dressing or premix carpet should be used. Next is the resurfacing. This is taken up by the pavement when the pavement has deteriorated badly. When the pavement is of inadequate thickness, or overlay of adequate thickness should be designed and provided. So this is resurfacing. The practice for maintenance of bituminous surface, Indian Road Congress, New Delhi, defects caused in defects in bituminous surfacing. So this is the table. Actually the table came down in my notes. So the practice for maintenance of bituminous surfaces in Indian Road Congress, New Delhi, 1982, the defect, symptoms, causes and treatments of defects in bituminous surfacing are given in this table. You can have a look. These are the types of the defects, the symptoms which can be detected, and the probable causes are this. And these are the possible treatments for the surface defect, like fatty surface, smooth surface, like cracks, like alligator cracks, longitudinal cracks and shrinkage cracks, deformations, सॉरी जस्ट अ सेकेंड, डिफॉर्मेशंस एंड डिसइंटीग्रेशंस, जस्ट यू कैन गो थ्रू द टेबल वंस. फाइनली वी अराइव टू द मेंटेनेंस ऑफ द कॉन्क्रीट पेवमेंट्स. सो दीज आर ड्यू टू द कॉन्क्रीट पेवमेंट्स, द डिफेक्ट्स आर ड्यू टू मेनली द इंक्रीज ऑफ वाटर, स्पेशली थ्रू इल मेंटेन्ड जॉइंट्स एंड क्रैक्स, इन एडिक्वेट पेवमेंट थिकनेस एंड पोअर वर्कमैनशिप. सो बेसिकली द डिफेक्ट्स विच वी सीन इन एनी अदर कॉन्क्रीट कंस्ट्रक्शन कैन बी सीन ऑल्सो सीन इन द कॉन्क्रीट पेवमेंट्स. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ देम इज द क्रैक्स. क्रैक्स आर वेरी कॉमन इन कॉन्क्रीट यू नो, एंड दिस मे बी ड्यू टू आइदर बाई श्रिंकेज और बाई वार्पिंग, and mainly or can be due to the temperature changes. The cracks appear in the corner and the edges and they are known as the structural cracks. They indicate the inadequacy of the pavement thickness and should be viewed seriously and treated differently. Hair cracks are not harmful, but hairline cracks, you know, they are not harmful, but medium and wide cracks actually allow water to seep. So basically the hair cracks don't actually cause any damage to the strength of the pavement, but the presence, but whenever these cracks widen, there is a chance that water may seep and can cause progressive loss of the subgrade support, and thus these cracks are not encourageable and should be filled up with low viscosity epoxy grout. After cleaning the cracks of the dust, this shall be done and the compressed air is used for effective cleaning. Next comes the joint. The joint maintenance consists of replenishing lost sealant, removal of deteriorated joint filler and introduction of fresh filler material. So joints can be simply repaired by introducing new filler materials, fresh filler materials, or by removal of deteriorated joint filler. The sealant is then poured to an excess height of about 3 mm and sand sprinkled for it for compressed by the traffic to the level of pavement surface. Next is the patch repair of slabs. Sealing, spalling, depression and irregularities, this occur in slab locally. These are the local issues of slabs. Local issues of slabs. And premix bituminous materials are commonly used for this purpose. To repair the patches, we use premix bituminous materials. The mix will be prepared previously and they do not provide a satisfactory result. Also, just keep it in mind, they don't provide satisfactory results. Though economical, they don't provide satisfactory result. The best material is the epoxy resin mortars and concrete for such patch repair work. The sides of the area of the slabs to be patched are trimmed, made vertical, and fresh concrete is laid and tamped. The areas are usually made of regular geometrical shapes like rectangles. Mud pumping, when the mud gets collected in the subgrade, heavy axle loads cause ejection of mud through joints, cracks, and edges. So mud can also get collected in the subgrade. This phenomenon is known as the mud pumping or blowing. So the heavy axle loads cause ejection of the mud through the joint, cracks and edges. As you know, the subgrade material is made up of soil and heavy axle load over the surface can sometimes lead to the ejection of the mud through the joints and cracks. This phenomenon is known as the mud pumping and blowing, and prevent this, further damage and recurrence, grouting of the slab is done through holes drilled in it. So grouting is the technique that can be used to save this type of situations, and grout can be of the cement mortar 1:3:5 mix or of bituminous materials. The latter shall be is preferred since it is effective in filling the void spaces between the slab and subgrade. Bituminous material is preferred because it is effective in filling the void spaces between the slabs and the subgrades. Restoration of the anti-skid surface. When the surface becomes smooth and slippery, anti-skid resistance can be restored by cutting grooves by grooving machines or by grinding machines. Next is the crack repair. A patching mix of epoxy mortar can be filled and compacted after chipping off the area and cleaning it thoroughly by using compressed air. So the cracks are first chipped off, then they are cleaned by compressed air, and then epoxy mortar can be filled and compacted to repair the cracks. So there is a diagram showing the crack repair by cross stitching. Just go through it. This is the longitudinal joint, and a tie bar is used, and the epoxy resin adhesive is applied through it. Mechanized maintenance of roads. Now the roads needs to be maintained by machines. So in India, you know, the road maintenance is mostly by labor oriented. However, mechanical maintenance of roads can be practiced with indigenous equipments for speedy implementation and better quality control. So use of machines can be done because they are good for the good in the terms of quality control, and the work can be done in a faster speed. So it has a speedy implementation. So maintenance management system MMS, in view of the several steps and factors involved in the maintenance operation of highways, system approach. So we use the system approach, and it is considered desirable to evolve an efficient maintenance program for any highway network. A computer package known as the pavement management system has been formulated to facilitate optimal resource allocation for maintenance. So the elements are basic road data bank. There's a bank where all the road data will be kept. Pavement performance model. So the pavement performance model are developed thereafter. Selection of the maintenance level. Also the maintenance level for different kinds of roads are selected. That is how much maintenance is required for a particular road. This thing has some selection criteria. So we go through it, and finally evolving priorities of maintenance, renewal and overlay. Suppose a road has simple hairline cracks and another road is full of potholes and is of more use by road users. So the second road has to be given preference over the previous one for maintenance. And several organizations have developed their own MMS package and implemented them in respective countries. So every country is to have their own MMS package. So that's all for the highway maintenance. So I don't think any doubt shall arise regarding this thing. The notes are given in the description below. The link for the notes is given. And if you have any doubts still, you can post it in the comment section. Also like and share my video, subscribe to the channel if you are new. Thank you.